Joy says 22.
I'm gonna turn it down. My name is Kalila Joy. My name is Kalila Joy. Welcome to my channel again. Sorry, it's been a minute. I've been doing some renovating around my home. You know, cleaning, painting, stuff like that. We're gonna do a spiritual message today. It's a general reading. We're gonna, you know, how to spell love or whatever. Let's just mute this, cause this is this. I think I feel like I'm talking over it. How y'all been doing? What's going on? Love, oh Lord. Maybe this reading is about to be about love. We wanna see what Spirit has to say. We're gonna get some guidance from Spirit, your ancestors. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, angels. We come to you for guidance, for the white light of protection. Spirit of the living God, fall fresh on these cards and my messages. Help me deliver what needs to be known. Amen. Again, damn. Okay, I'm just gonna get right into the message instead of talking so much. Choices. Check in with God. Check in with the white light of protection, your angels, your ancestors. Thank you, Jesus. Your synchronicities, they've been sending you signs and symbols. The Spirit wants you to accept responsibility for your choices in your past. Your past is what got you here to today. So be at peace with that. Serenity. Be at peace with that. All right. Let's go into the energy for the collective. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for those messages. Let's go into the energy for the collective. Okay? Holy Spirit. What energy do I have for my collective? First card we got is the angel of love is in reverse. Grounded, the one that holding the coin in reverse. Whew. That's a lot of karmic energy. Since the first about a love situation. You need to pay, be mindful of your choices. Pay attention to the signs it's warning you. This lack of choice that you're making, or this potential toxic choice that you will make, could lead to some, be aware that it can lead to some lack in abundance. It could set you back. Pay attention to the signs, the red flags. And because we have love in the beginning, I'm assuming that this is about love. Upside down. The majority of the cards upside down. I don't like to start off with reversals because that's kind of delicious, but whatever. Alright, spirit. Let's get into it. Thank you, Holy Spirit. What is this angel of love and indecision in? You or someone need to make a decision on love or have not been able to. The star, all the situations. Healing. So we got the star. Ooh. Ten of Cups. Working. So some of you need to make a decision. Decisive about your career or your money. Know that it is healing. You are, it's going to lead to some type of wish fulfillment. You are working hard and focusing on yourself. You are healing. Spirit wants you to know that. The choices you have made so far, some of you took a back seat to love for now because it was blocking, or you felt like you seen signs of it blocking your abundance. So you took a step back from it. Maybe you was in some type of toxic or karmic situation. Will of Fortune, oh yes. Ooh, I was worried for a minute, y'all. Haggity lie. With this Cornucopia in reverse, know that the cycle is turning. The wheel is moving forward. Who's still crying over spilled milk? Someone's still crying over spilled milk. Something happened in your past. Blocking your door, your personal healing and your growth. Do not be aware of that. Focusing on what happened in the, ooh, the Emperor. Oh Lord, that's someone, divine counterpart, divine masculine or feminine. Taking how it resonates. Oh. Grounded. Some of you need to be patient. Oh Lord, be aware that you might be getting in some type of battle or with some type of competition regarding this love interest. Yeah, some of you still sad. Right, you're being focused on this love that's been lost, that's in the reverse. Be aware that it's, this is going to lead to personal healing and growth. These two cups behind you, you still got two cups behind you. You have to ground yourself. Some type of competition. You might get in a fight or an argument with somebody. If y'all want time, this reading is timeless, but for the sake of time, let's just say to the end of January, since we got in January. What else, Spirit? Oh, the world. Yes, you are fighting for your peace. Some type of cycle is about to end. Oh, Empress at the bottom. Y'all see Empress? That's a bad bitch. Yes. future. Ooh, some of you about to get new love. Or new love is coming in as soon as you quit crying over the past and what's already spilled and done with. I see you, most of you guys are working on your abundance. Need to be aware of some type of toxic person from your past. Quit crying over spilled milk. If you're going to forgive, forgive. Be mindful of your choices, though. You need to get grounded. There's some type of competition out here with this emperor. Healing right now, and you want the cycle to close. The cycle is closed. You're about to go into a new beginning. Wheel of Fortune, World card, new beginning. Five of Wands, fighting off this competition or fighting off some type of temptation. I'm glad to know that you guys are healing and y'all been paying attention to your sacred entities. Woman of male with the coin. Let's see what's going on. Oh, we got Ten of Cups. Again. Okay. Someone want to equally give and take with you guys. I don't like to make my readings just about love, but some of you are getting right about to get into some abundance. I see a new job offered or a new project that you've been working on really hard. This is going to bring some type of new abundance. You're going to be the empress or the emperor. Both of them is out here. I see a power couple. Both fell out here. Boom. Let's see what spirit wants to say. What's going on? Two of Wands. Some type of, you made some type of decision. In the past, you decided to work on yourself and your abundance. The spirit is letting you know that you're the choice. By you choosing to focus on yourself and work on your project, it's going to pay off. Some of you still may be crying over a love that you thought was your divine master or divine feminine. Yeah, somebody from your past. This person looks like they're coming back. It may be a fight. Might end up arguing and fighting with this person. Somebody want to put down a burden. Because you've been trying to put down this burden. Why does this emperor or empress want to come back? They want to offer you some type of love, but it's karmic. Could be Nine of Pentacles. Yeah, this person is going to try to move in real fast. Went on the Ten of Wands in reverse. This is all karmic energy. This could be a karmic soulmate trying to come back. Pay attention to the sign. Be aware. Ooh. Nine of Swords. King of Pentacles. This person could be coming back for your money. After you already have put down this burden or coming back to offer you some type of money. But it looked like you put a stop to it. Ace of Pentacles. Oh, some type of Ace of, yeah. Ace of Pentacles, Two of Wands. Yeah, in the past, somebody could make some type of decision, so you decided to go heal yourself, work on your projects and your abundance. You are in the Ten of Pentacles energy. You're no longer crying over spilled milk. You are now in your Empress, the Empress, Emperor, or Empress. Gender does not count. Energy, the person or the people you've been dealing with, love or money, that's in the past. They may try to come back and offer a cup of love. Spirit is telling you, asking you to put down this burden. It may be a fight or argument with these people or this person. But you got some, you run some type of victory.
victory, or you're about to get some type of victory. The people you're dealing with, you have moved forward from this bullshit. And it's the people from your past. Yep, you got the Chariot and the Hangman. Yes, these people are stuck. They want to be stuck in the same old cycle. You decided to move forward. That's good. Spirit wants you to keep moving forward. You are the King of Pentacles. Some type of new offer or new beginning is coming towards you. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Let's see what the angels and the ancestors want to tell you. Okay. I'm just going to take off. yourself from them because you decided to take a new journey, to go on a new path. And spirit has sent you signs and synchronicity about this individual, so you decide to move forward.
And since this is
a lot of reverse, clarify. Somebody from your past is in the reverse coming to offer some love. Spirit, what about this, these people from the past? What is their intention? Or what's going on with them? Stuck in their head, knowing that they betrayed you, they're coming out of some betrayal, knowing that they weren't giving, this is no equal give or take. This person just recently broke up or in the process of a divorce, and they want got the world part at the end of the day. Ooh, some type of tower moment. So I had to make a decision about a path, two cups in reverse, three of swords. Oh, third party situation, yeah. Someone lied about their relationship status or about what they want out of the situation. Be aware that somebody's been stuck in their head. They know that they betrayed you. They were not giving to you or the situation, the person you're thinking about. I'm just going to keep 100. Spirit up here saying for choices, be aware of your choices and pay attention to the signs. Look like in the outcome, you're going to choose to be at peace, don't fight, and some type of new beginning is coming in for you. More, and you got the world card under the clarifying deck. But give me more on this new beginning, Spirit. Devil, or some type of attachment. told me that this indecision about some type of project or money or hobby or whatever that you're doing, you're not supposed to be doing it for recognition or reward. Don't do it. Because you complicate your life like that. And when you don't get the results that you were suspecting out of others, you don't feel like that you made some type of victory. For example, I don't want to say that I started my YouTube channel for some type of recognition or approval or reward, but I guess I was trying to do some type of validation. And I had to stand back and question myself, like, why am I doing this and who am I doing it for? Well, I am on my healing journey. I have been on it for years now. And I do love people and I do have a passion for helping others. And I figure out this is an outlet to help others. I'm not gonna even lie at the fact that, you know, the fact that YouTube is booming. You know, a lot of people make a lot of money off of YouTube. But that's not the only reason why. If that's the case, then I would be on here 24/7. So, to make my life more simple, I just do what Spirit calls me to do it. Because I'm not doing it for recognition and I'm not doing it for a praise or nothing. You do it because you're passionate about it, or do it because you're passionate about something. And this is a part of your journey. Move forward. Be clear on who and what and why. And I just gave an example about my hobby when I do this YouTube stuff on the side. Because you make your life more complicated. I don't want to make YouTube my job, my career, my money source, or something that I have to depend on. If I'm doing it for that, then I don't need to do it, because it's going to make the, and I'm only using that as an example because it's only going to make your life more complicated, because if you don't get the results or the views or the feedback or whatever that you want, you're going to, for one, feel like you're facing some type of judgment, and for two, you want to just quit. So that's why I say all my readings are timeless, because I never know when I'm going to come back on here. I mean, whenever I feel pulled to do it, I just do it. And do it for the right reasons. And that's what any aspect of your life. Okay? I like that message. I like that tip. Y'all want another one? Let's take one from the top. It says, are you willing to exercise your power today? All thought is a conscious power. If you think you can do it, you can. Yes. Just do it. Keep it simple. Keep it so simple. Don't do it to try to impress nobody. Just flow with it. And that was another issue. I was trying to figure out, like, how I'm going to do my platform, or, you know, what I'm going to talk about or whatever, but it wouldn't be an impact. Or some people call it talking to spirits or whatever you want to call it, psychic thing. If you had to script it, you cannot script stuff like this. And that's another thing I had to learn. You know, like, you know, sometimes everything don't need, yes, you do need a business plan. Don't get me wrong on that. I always say, yes, you need a business plan, but you don't have to be so detailed about it. Keep it simple. Just flow it. Flow it. Write it down. Figure it out. When you get to it, you get to it. Flow with it. Okay? All right. Well, that's my messages for today. Just love you being, be aware of type of devil energy out here. Person probably still attached to the devil. Somebody been resting though. Somebody released themselves from some type of higher level, or trying to release themselves from some type of higher level commitment. They're stressed out of body. Pay attention to the signs. Some type of somebody gonna be fighting. Be patient. Trouble don't last always. Put down his burden. King of Pentacles is here. New love. He's going on a new journey. Either you're going on a new journey with this individual from the past. But you got the Ace of Pentacles here, you're about to receive some type of victory. And everybody ain't gonna be happy. But be aware of your choices, because you could be blocking your abundance. I believe God do not want to bless you with people who don't deserve to be blessed with you. Okay? That's as simple as that. Everybody can't go with you. Everybody shouldn't have a part of your abundance. And I know for sure. As soon as I start cutting people or things that's attached to this devil off, that's when stuff starts falling through and coming in for me. So, all this people pleasing and staying attached to situations that you know that will no longer serve you, you have to put that burden down. And become decisive about what you want, how you want it, and how you plan on getting it, or how you want to get it. Okay? Thank you all. Thank you for visiting my channel. Please like, share, subscribe.